In this video, we're going to be exploring kinetic facades, and I'm going to be showing you how to build this kinetic facade, which basically means it's a facade that moves according to the parameters that you set. We're going to be building a parametric panel family, which you can adapt to a curtain wall, and then you can make interesting facades like this one. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and to create this panel facade or this kinetic facade, we need to create our parametric panel. And for that, let's go here to families and then let's click on new. I'm going to go one step back so I can select the metric family template library. And then here you want to search for a metric curtain panel, just the regular one, and then hit open. So as soon as this opens up, then we need to set up all of the reference planes for this model. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go here to the right elevation in the project browser, and then let's start placing some reference planes. So for reference planes, you want to go here to create and then go to work plane to set some reference planes. And now I'm just going to go here to the create tab, go to datum panel, and here we have the reference plane tool. RP is the shortcut. And first I'm just going to create three small reference planes here, dividing the height into four segments. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then we want to add some dimensions. So for dimensions, you can go here to the quick access toolbar, align the dimension, DI is the shortcut, and then I'm just going to set it here from the bottom to the top to get the entire length. And then I'm also going to add one here connecting all of these individual reference planes, place it here, and then I'm just going to hit EQ to equalize the distances. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then let's continue placing some reference planes. So for that, let's go back to create, back to reference plane, and then here I'm just going to create an offset reference plane. So what this will be basically an offset from the actual panel. So usually you won't have these kind of on the glass, you would have them just a little bit offset. So let's create that offset. And of course, we need to add a dimension. So I'm just going to add a dimension here, hit the escape key a couple of times. So we have that 100 millimeter offset on this exterior side. Okay, so now it makes sense to turn some of these into parameters. So let's select this dimension here, then go to label. Now we don't really have any parameters created, so let's go to create parameter, and I'm just going to call this one total height. Then I'm just going to click OK. And also for this offset parameter, I'm just going to create it and let's call it the panel offset. And you can keep it as a type parameter and then just click OK. Okay, so now moving forward, we need to create kind of the structure in terms of reference planes and reference lines that's going to allow us to create movement inside of this family. So to do that, let's go back to create, and then on the datum panel, now you want to select the reference line. So you want to select the reference line and you want to start from this intersection here and just go out at any angle pretty much, just like this, and then hit the escape key a couple of times. Now you want to make sure that this point here is locked in into this position. Now we can do that by using the align tool. So just go to the modify tab and then select the align tool. AL is the shortcut. First, you want to align it here at the bottom. So I'm just going to use the tab key to select the reference plane at the bottom and then just click. And now we want to select the bottom of that line. Now you don't want to select the line. You want to hit the tab key until you get this little point, and then you want to lock that point to that reference plane. Same thing goes here vertically. So select the reference plane, hit the tab key once or twice to get that point, and then lock in that point so it's always going to stay there in place. Now we can hit the escape key a couple of times, and now let's create the angle parameter. So for that, we want to go here to the modify tab or to annotation and then find the angular dimension. just like this. You want to go from here, from the reference plane, to our reference line, and then let's place this dimension here and hit the escape key a couple of times. Now, these dimensions can sometimes seem a bit too large, so you can always change your scale to make it a bit smaller if this is necessary. So now I'm just going to select this dimension, then let's turn that into a parameter as well by going here to create parameter. And then for this one, this will be an instance parameter, and let's call it the open angle. Then you just want to click OK, and we have that parameter in place. Now let's create the other side of this. So let's go back here to create, let's go here to reference line, and then let's create a reference line from here up to here. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Okay, so what we want to do with this one is we also want to lock it in place. So you can go here to the align tool and just make sure that you align this point with this vertical reference plane. Again, use the tab key to make the selection. Okay, so now let's hit the escape key a couple of times and let's place another angle dimension here. So let's go again here to, let's find it here, angular dimension, go from the bottom to here, place it there, hit the escape key a couple of times. Now we can select this dimension and I can go here to label and I can just pick out my open angle just because we're going to be using the same parameter. And now this is adjusted. We can just bring it back in and now it seems to be in the correct place. Okay, so now we want to test it by flexing it. So you flex the families by going here to the family types, open that up, and then here we can, let me just perhaps zoom in this a little bit better, like that. Okay, so now here, if I change the angle to something like 30 and then hit apply, it's going to go down. If I go to 10, it's going to go even lower. If I go to 85, it's going to be quite high, like this. So you can basically play around and set it up wherever you like. And now we do need to set the actual length of one of these segments, which is actually going to control, well, both of the segments. So what you want to do for that is just add an additional dimension and turn it into a parameter. So for that, let's go here to the quick access toolbar, select the aligned dimension, go from this point here, again, use the tab key to select the point itself, then go to this point here, again, use the tab key to select the point and place it just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select that dimension, and then let's go here and create a new parameter. This will be an instance parameter, or no, actually this will be the type parameter. And then here for the name, let's call it the panel length. Then you just want to click, actually, let's make it, leave it an as an instance parameter and then click OK. Okay, just like that. And now let's set up a formula. So basically, as you can see from this, we're going to have one of these on the bottom and one of these on top. And let me just move this out of the way. Okay, so with that said, that means that basically each one of these segments should fill in one of these gaps. So basically we have four of them, so that's going to be quarter of this total height. So we just need to set up a formula that's going to, well, do that. So for that, let's open up our family types. And then here, I'm just going to select our total height, Control C. And then here for our panel length, I'm just going to paste that and divide that by four. So now we have a formula. We have our total height divided by four, which gives us our panel length or panel height, whatever. So now let's hit the apply and click OK. And now as you can see, this has been adjusted to that. So no matter basically what the height is, it's just going to feed that information down here. Okay, so we have all of this set and now let's apply actual geometry. So we've used reference planes here because when you select a reference plane, you can see it has these or reference lines. Reference lines are made out of reference planes. So now what I can do is I can go here to create, go to extrusion, then I can use set work plane and let's go with pick a plane. PK is the shortcut. And see, when I hover over this line, it creates a reference plane around that line. And now I can just use pick lines and pick this line, lock it in place. Let's give it a 30 millimeter offset. Place it there, and then let's reduce the offset to zero, go to regular lines and create a line here, and a line there. Now, just to be safe, I like to add an aligned dimension from here to here and lock it in place. You don't really have to do this, but it is an option, so I'm just going to do that just to be sure. And then basically, I'm just going to repeat the same thing on this side here above. We just want to create another extrusion as a panel. Okay, so now once we have two of these, let's adjust their size or the width. So let's go here to reference level, and then here we just want to extend that and lock it in place on both sides like this. Let's do the same thing with the one on the bottom, lock it on both sides, just like that. And now I like to test it, and I actually like to see this in two views. So here we have that 3D view, so that's this. And then let's go to our right elevation, and I'm just going to dock it here onto the side. Let's see. Okay, just like that. Okay, so let's just make that 3D a bit smaller. Okay, so this is basically what we have. This is the 3D view, this is the 2D view, and now let's flex this. So I'm just going to open up family types. Where can I hide this? Okay, so just let's do it like this. So if I set this to 5 degrees and hit apply, as you can see, it's going to extend almost to the top. If I set this to 85, it's going to just go down and collapse. So basically, we can just play around with this parameters, and it's going to basically change the change how this louver or these panels move. And then we just need to repeat the entire process on top, and then we're going to get the completed panel. And once it's done, this is what that looks like. Let me change this to shaded. There we go. Now we can test it out. Now here's something that I've just noticed along the way. It does make sense to have the total height parameter as an instance parameter. So that's just something that I've changed. And now if we test this out, we can have it almost completely closed like this. We can even have it completely closed if we want, or we can have it open and so on. You can even go to 90 degrees. So anyways, this does seem to be working. So now let's test it out in a project. So for that, let's go here to file, let's go to new project, and then let's pick out the metric full multi-discipline template. Click OK. And now as soon as that opens up, I'm just going to place a single curtain wall storefront, and then let's go like this. So one large curtain wall. Let's go to the 3D view, see what that looks like. Now here, I'm just going to make a change. I'm going to connect this to level 2, and then also I'm going to go into edit type, and here I'm just going to change the spacing, the horizontal spacing to 4,000 millimeters so we can get these large high panels. Okay, having done that, we can go back to our family. We can load that into the project, go to the 3D view. Now let's select this curtain wall, go into edit type, and now let's change the curtain panel from system panel glazed to our panel. So let's see where it is. Here we go. This is the one. Apply. Okay. And this is what we have. Now, when you select one of these panels here, you can see we have the opening angle, so you can set it up to whatever you like. So here I can set this to, I don't know, something like 80. degrees, and that's going to open up. I can come and select this one and say, okay, I want 90 degrees on this one. And then this one, I can say, okay, I want 80 as well. So I can kind of create some gradients or something like that. Let's go with 60 on this one, and let's go with 40 on this one, just like that, creating kind of an interesting opening. This one we can go to, I don't know, like 40, and this one we can completely close up by setting it to 0. So that's basically how these panels work. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you like this. It's quite an interesting topic. And to be honest, I thought this would be way more complicated to do. However, as you can see, it's not really that complicated. So I hope you have enjoyed it. If you want to get access to this Revit project file or all of my Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.